Hi, I'm Phil. 10 years ago, I lost my wife and lost my job, and I decided to change my lifestyle. My wife and I always wanted a boat, so I decided to buy the boat, and I named it Annie's Dream. And I've been living on it ever since. I spent a year on the River Thames, and then I came down on the Kennet and Avon, and I've been on here for the last nearly nine years. I choose to cruise the Kennet and Avon because it goes through Wiltshire, which is a beautiful county, and I'm passionate about landscape photography, and it's literally on my doorstep. So this is my life. And this is my dog Bailey. When we first got on the boat, I had another one, but she sadly passed away a couple of years ago. Bailey, he's now 13. But it's a lovely lifestyle for a dog. We walk and run miles. It's just out in the wild is what a dog should be doing. And he's my best friend. He's my soulmate. I'm classed as a continual cruiser because I don't want to live in a marina or be fixed in one point. To be a continual cruiser, you have to cruise your boat, but you have to do 21 miles in one direction over a year. But the beauty of it is the neighbours are noisy. You can just bump in the boat, fire it up and just move a few hundred yards down the canal. You'll always find me in a quiet spot because I like my quiet life. My friends and neighbours on the canal are very varied, from people who can just barely survive a living to nurses, artists, poetry people, IT consultants. There's all sorts of people on the canal, very varied, and there's some real characters.
Hello, my name's Peter, and I live on a narrow boat called Grey Hare, which is just here. And I've known Phil for about 5 years, and we meet up and down the Kennet and Avon Canal. These are a selection of some of the sticks I make when I cut wood from the hedgerow, and I sell them at floating markets along the Kennet and Avon Canal. The main materials I use is holly, hazel, hawthorn, blackthorn, and if I can find it, some ornamental plum. The heads are resin, which I buy from a friend I know, and also I use antler and black buffalo horn, which is rather nice. The stick I'm holding at the moment is made out of holly. I collected it about 7-10 years ago, spent several years drying it out. When it was dry, I stripped the bark off, dug out the honeysuckle which was around it, and this is my signature stick to promote the hare, grey hare walking sticks. And the other one I have here, this is made out of ivy with black buffalo horn for the join onto the antler with a quartz crystal. And I use this one every Christmas, just before Christmas Day, as I've become a green Father Christmas for the children who live on the cut.
And everybody loves the lifestyle, and everybody looks after one another. It's like they call it the longest village in the country. We've got 2,000-3,000 miles of waterways. When I decided to get a boat, I saw this one and it was up in Blackburn, and I fell in love with it straight away. And Sean, the guy who built the boat, I said to him, look, I want the boat. He said, well, there's loads of people after the boat. And I said, no, I want this boat. And if I get the boat, I'm going to call it Annie's Dream. And I told him the story that my wife died and she always wanted a boat. and he stood there saying, you make sure you sell your house, Phil, and I'll make sure you get the boat. I had a phone call from the estate agent, and she phoned me up and she said, Phil, would you accept full asking price, cash buyer, but you've got to be out in 8 weeks? So I said, yes. And it happened. So it was just meant to be.
So back in the 80s is where I really got involved with the canal in operating a steam dredger and tugs and barges. And that took me on to becoming a lock keeper on the Basingstoke Canal, looking after the deep cut flight of locks, where I lived in the top cottage at lock 28. We have a floating market on the Kennet and Avon Canal down in Bradford-on-Avon. We have this year been trying markets down in Biaff, and also Newbury and Devizes. So it'll be interesting to see how things pan out in expanding. But it's a lot of movement for boats to go from one venue to another.
So Pete mentioned the floating market at the Devizes. So today I've come to see who's here and what's on offer. Hi, my name's Steve and my boat's called Benjamin. I sell sweets from the boat with a business called the Sweet Barge. Started on the canal 12 years ago. I was going to try it to see how I enjoyed it for a year, but I've liked it so much I've never moved away. And then I started up this business to help me travel around and be part of the community. And I've been a carpenter, I've taught carpentry, I've also been a musician and taught music. But this is a nice, relaxed lifestyle, and I can't see me changing it.
Hi, I'm Ziggy. My business is Shine on the Water. It's a collaboration between Wire Witch and Shine on the Water. My partner does the jewellery, I do the brass, and the boat's called Trinity Jean. I also do knife sharpening, axe sharpening, soldering. We will be leaving the Kennet and Avon next year because we're going down to London, but we would like to be able to come back here. So we're going to leave a legacy, and hopefully the traders on the Kennet and Avon will carry on doing the markets.
Hi, my name's Sam Kay. My boat name is East of the Sun, and my business name is Cake on the Cut. And underneath Cake on the Cut, I also do gangplank gins. I've always traditionally done and been brought up with my damson gin and sloe gin, probably like most of us. So I've always done that as Christmas presents for people. And last winter I did that and then thought, well, I'll add that to my Cake on the Cut and see if people like it. And they loved it. So I buy just the base London gin and then I instill them with botanicals and foraged fruits. Some fruits I buy if I have to, and then some fruits are given to me by customers. I think I've chosen my lifestyle because I love the freedom of the canal life. I love the fact there's an adventure around the corner, and I can be my own boss and be in beautiful places.
I sit here content, my thoughts and my feelings, remembering who I used to be.
In the longer term, I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm enjoying my lifestyle at the moment. I will do it as long as I can. Then when I become a burden on society, I'll have to decide what I'm going to do then. I'll worry about that later. At the moment, I'm enjoying myself too much.
The beauty of living on the canal system is we have a fantastic community where everyone watches out for each other and supports people in their need and enjoy life. We cruise around, moving every 2 weeks, and yeah, fantastic life we have.